Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. First and foremost, alhamdulillah, we praise Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for making it possible to have such an important great gathering, and we are greatly indebted to Shaykh Abdul Rahman Bawa and his son for organizing such an important event. I'm not going to give a lecture, I'm just going to say Jazakallah khairan for bringing the effort, highlighting the significance of the continuity in the struggle of bringing and implementing and making that serious concern in defending the finality of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You have heard the lecturers, you have heard the great ulama and the speakers, all have highlighted the importance of the Quran, and it is sufficient in the experience that we have been facing and the challenges that we had there in South London, which is now resonating in different parts of the country. What we would like to highlight, if for example, there was a Quran exhibition that took place even after the conference that was held there, including Islamic Center, and those from the South London, a youngster had went inside there, he seen the displays of Mirza Ghulam Ahmed, he seen the Quran exhibition, and see how great the deception was. And he brings back so many booklets. If you only you had seen those booklets, probably there would be many who would not be even aware of the difference between the Quran, and they would really think that they are Muslims. So that is why it is important to continue this effort and highlighting the great difference. Because yes, when we're speaking about Ahl al-Kitab, Ta'alu ila kalimatin, we are not the Qadiani and Ahmadiyya, they're not even from the Ahl al-Kitab because they are not Muslims. Just one example, rejecting one verse of the Holy Quran, that is sufficient to take them out of the fold of Islam. There are many, many examples, but when the youngster brings back books that Jesus, or tomb, died in India, and his tomb is there in Kashmir, that alone goes against rejecting one verse of the Holy Quran. وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ وَلَكِنْ شُبِّيَ لَهُمْ. They did not kill him, they did not crucify him, a resemblance was placed over him. Allah Ta'ala had elevated him and raised him up to the heaven. So the Qadiani and the Ahmadiyya, by their belief only that Isa alayhi salam died a physical death and he's buried there in Kashmir, that belief and that aqidah automatically takes them out of the fold of Islam. We do not even have to go, you have already seen the verses how clearly highlighted. And I would end with this verse, مَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ أَبَا أَحَدٍ مِنْ رِجَالِكُمْ وَلَكِ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَخَاتَمَ النَّبِيِّينَ. Muhammad, he is not the father of any one of you men, he is the seal of the prophets, he is the messenger of Allah, and he is the seal of the prophets. May Allah Ta'ala give us all the tawfiq, the ability, the courage, not to have any fear, to continue the struggle, to engage in the importance, because what we are facing now is that there are many youngsters that have come, for example, there at the Islamic Center, personal experience, to have the nikah performed. So what do we do? We have to adopt a method and a way not to turn them and reject them, because there are those that have accepted Islam. So we are welcoming them and say, yes, you can come and learn about Islam. And that is why, because they are going together in university, they are growing up together and taking the law of the land into consideration. We have to have that some type of effort and da'wah to at least bring them into Islam, because we have no doubt and we have the firm yaqeen that they are not Muslims. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for all those who are facing such type of challenges.
Please carry on a little longer.
It's only given 5 minutes.